Hello all. In this session, in the same module 4, that is Global Environmental Concerns, we are going to discuss about greenhouse effect and the climatic change and also the human activity. First one is greenhouse effect. This greenhouse effect, which is natural process that warms the earth's surface, and when the sun's energy reaches the earth's atmosphere, some of it's reflected back to the space and rest, which is observed and also which is radiated by the greenhouse gases. And also a progressive warming up of the earth's surface due to high concentration of man-made carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. And also the natural outcome is a warmer atmosphere, that is 100 years ago, CO2, that is 275 ppm. In the year 2007, like 375 ppm. In the year 2040, it is expected like 450 ppm. And greenhouse effect, that objects that absorbs all the radiation upon them is called the black body. And also the earth is close to being the black body absorber, that is gases on the other hand are selective in their absorption characteristics. While many gases does not absorb radiation at all, some selectively absorb only at certain wavelengths. And those gases that are selective absorbers of solar energy, which is gases, we known as greenhouse gases. And the greenhouse effect is a phenomenon, that creates the condition of upper atmosphere and causing a trapping of excess heat and leading to the increase of the surface temperatures. Here we can observe in this figure like infrared radiation is emitted by the earth's surface, and next there will be some of the infrared radiation passes through the atmosphere, and some which is absorbed and re-emitted in all the directions by the greenhouse gas molecules. And the effect of this, which is warm the earth's surface and the lower atmosphere, most of the radiation is absorbed by the earth's surface and which is warmed it. And some solar radiation is reflected by the earth and the atmosphere. And the major greenhouse effect, the major greenhouse effects in the major greenhouse effect gases, the gases with the properties of greenhouse, which is known as greenhouse gases. And some gases in earth's atmosphere, for example, water, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, have a very special property. And also they do not absorb the visible light from the sun, but they do absorb the infrared light radiation by the earth's surface. This is called greenhouse gases. And carbon dioxide, halogen gases like chlorofluorocarbons, CFC, that is nitrogen oxide, methane, etc., will be the other gases. And there's before going to the climatic change, like greenhouse effect and the the global warming, which is the difference, like global warming, which is the gradual increase in the overall temperature of the earth atmosphere due to the greenhouse effect, and the greenhouse effect that warming the earth's atmosphere due to the buildup of heat trapping gases, which is such as carbon dioxide and methane. Like scientists refer to these pollutants as a greenhouse gases. And why this greenhouse effect is which is important, in our planet, which is holding up some of the earth's heat energy so that it does not escapes into the space, the heat trapping is known as a greenhouse effect, just has to to trap. It's known as greenhouse effect. Just has to little greenhouse makes the earth's too cold, and too much of greenhouse gases makes earth's too warmer. Okay, next one is climate. In this climatic change, climate variably includes all the variations in the climate, like that the weather, individual weather events may be going to change, and whereas the term climatic change only refers to those variations which is having a long period of time, typically the decades like that. Okay, what are the causes for this you know, the climatic change. Greenhouse gases play a very important role in the atmosphere, in the Earth's climate cycles. As the planet gets heat, when the planet gets hit with the sun rays, like some of the energy which is absorbed and the rest of that energy and the heat gets reflected into space. And the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere trap the reflected energy. It is redirected it back down to the earth, and eventually it is contributing to the global warming. And various gases play this role, including the water vapor, carbon dioxide, that is CO2, methane, nitrous oxide, and chlorofluorocarbon, that is CFCs. Okay, next one, agriculture. There are many significant ways in which agriculture impacts the climate change. From deforestation in places like in Amazon to the transportation and livestock, that is takes to support agricultural efforts around the world. Like, agriculture is very much responsible for a significant portion of the world's greenhouse gas emission. However, agriculture is also an area that is make tremendous the strides to become more sustainable, and as productivity increases, less carbon is being emitted to produce the more food. Because the climatic change, periodic modification of the Earth's climate brought to the atmosphere, as well as interaction between the atmosphere in a different level, that is geological or chemical or biological, within the Earth's surface. And this greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, for example, such as carbon dioxide, methane, and the water vapor, which is absorbed the infrared radiation, and which is emitted from the Earth's surface, and the radiate back, and thus contributing to the greenhouse effect. And ice sheets, like ice, sea ice, or terrestrial vegetation, ocean temperatures, weathering, these are influenced either directly or indirectly, but the atmosphere, however, they are also feedback into the atmosphere, which is influenced into important influence with the importance with that. And periodic changes in Earth's orbit and the tilt with respect to the sun, like, affect how solar radiation is distributed on Earth's surface. And extreme weather changes, that is extreme weather changes, will be noticeable effect of climate change for average person. But one reason of this is financial impact of severe weather events can have. And according to the National Climatic Assessment, like, extreme weather events will continue to increase in frequency, and extreme weather influenced by climatic changes includes strong storms, heat waves, wildfires, flooding, heavier droughts, etc. And this climate variability includes all the variations in the climate that last longer than the individual weather events, whereas the term climate change only refers to those variations longer period of time, which is typically decades. And also, this climate system receives nearly all of these energies from the sun, but the climate system also radiates energy to the outer body and outer space or a body. And the balance of incoming and outgoing energy, maybe it is dependent. And the Earth moving through Earth's climatic system finds the weather may be varying on geographic aspects. And about deforestation. Deforestation and climatic change often go hand in hand, and also according to the Earth Day Network, like, deforestation is the second leading contributor for these global greenhouse gases. And many people and organizations fighting against the climatic change, like, point to reducing the deforestation, which is point to the deforestation of most of the important issues that must be addressed to slow or prevent the climate change. And the last one is human activity. According to the Environmental Protection Agency, the most significant contributor of climatic change will be United States in the burning of fossil fuels for the electricity, heat, and transportation. And also, these factors of transportation is a form of maybe trucks, ships, cars, trains, and planes, which emits the largest percentage of
carbon dioxide and speeding up the global warming and remaining significant cause the climate change. Thank you.